They had nothing else to lose. And they did what was necessary, put in the hours that were necessary. They did what was expected of them. 20 years later, you have Jamie Oliver, Gordon Ramsey, Top Chef, Masterchef, blah, blah, blah.
It's something unimaginable at the time, right?
Yeah, it was. It was really unimaginable. In fact, what was more unimaginable was people would pay money to go and learn how to do all this kind of stuff. Like, you know? What they don't teach you in these schools, especially in our Malaysian schools, is that the most basic prerequisite is to be able to stand for long hours. That's like a basic prerequisite. So you have to have a physical dexterity. If you can stand and you can move, you can be useful. You don't need to have like flair. You don't have to like, you know, sprinkle salt like that or sautee. You know, you don't have any of that. You just stand, you can be useful. It's a physically demanding job. It's a mentally and emotionally demanding job. I mean, you think about the amount of feedback that we get from Malaysians about the menu that we put out, and a lot of it's not good, and you put your heart out for it. You put your... I don't want to speak about this loosely, but you really put your heart out and you really do wear this craft of yours on the sleeve. And then just because someone disagree with it, so they try and shift opinion. It's weird. We have people like Christian who've been to the new restaurant. Christian traveled from Copenhagen to come and eat at our restaurant. So did the Locavore boys. And we've had like a few other chefs fly down just to come and celebrate our new space and to have our new menu. And these are friends and whom opinions I value. And they say it's an amazing experience. Then you have some guy in Malaysia who's like never been to more than like 10 of these restaurants or anything like that. And then they're so opinionated. They have so much to say. And does it affect me? Yes, it does affect me. And it's very hard to distance yourself from those words because you don't have an idea of how hard we work. You don't have an idea until you come and do a whole week with us. You don't have an idea. And so it's hurtful. But we just remind ourselves within our team and remind ourselves not to get distracted by things that shouldn't matter and keep our heads down and keep on doing our work.